Hey guys, welcome to Mock Question Monday. This week we're talking about the basic schedules of intermittent reinforcement, specifically the one that produces a post-reinforcement pause. And of course, the correct answer is fixed ratio. This is a schedule that produces a pattern of responding in which the individual completes required responses with very little hesitation. And the post-reinforcement pause follows the reinforcement. It's basically when the individual doesn't respond for a certain time following reinforcement. Now, the size of the ratio influences the duration of that pause. Large ratios, long pauses. Short ratios, short pauses. Now, in this schedule, there's often the production of high rates of responding because quick responding produces faster rates of reinforcement. So the larger the ratio requirement, the higher the rate of response for this particular schedule. Now, in contrast to variable ratio, which is the strongest basic schedule, this produces consistent, steady rates of response, no post-reinforcement pause. And maybe that's because the absence of information about when the next response will actually produce reinforcement, so the responding remains steady because, again, you never know if the next response will produce the reinforcement. Like the FR, there is a fast rate of response, and again, the larger the ratio requirements, the faster the rate of response, just like the fixed ratio. Now, letter C is kind of a trick. I hope you guys saw that it said fixed time and not fixed interval. Fixed time has to do with response independent schedules of reinforcement, like, for example, NCR, which we talked about last week. So in the fixed interval, which you probably confused with fixed time if you chose this, there is a post-reinforcement pause, but it's only in the very early part of the interval. And letter D, variable interval. This produces a very constant, stable pattern of response, very few hesitations between the responding. And there's also the production of the low to moderate rate of response. And in this one, the larger the average interval, the lower the overall rate of response. I hope that helps, guys. I'll see you next time.